is that there's no hereafter and there's nothing after this life. He will spend all his time and all his effort and whatever he has as an ability to make sure to gain the most in this life and create the most happiness that he can within this life.
أما إذا آمن بأن هناك حياة أخرى بأن هناك عالم آخر هذا العالم أيضا يريد أن يكون سعيدا فيه فحينئذ سوف يفكر عندما يريد أن يتصرف ويعمل كل عمل كل تصرف هل يؤثر على سعادتي في تلك الحياة الأخرى أم لا؟
But however, on the other side, if he believes there's a hereafter and there is another world, an everlasting world that is waiting for him after this life, and the real happiness and the real success is in that life, then whenever he makes any action or makes or takes any decision, he will think that this action or this decision in this life, how is going to impact the hereafter and how is going to impact the other life, every detail of these actions that he's going to take, and that will impact his decision making.
ولذلك كانت هناك رؤيتان وكان هناك خطان على صعيد البشرية خط ورؤية إلهية لعالم حياة أو فلسفة إلهية في حياتنا وهناك في مقابله فلسفة ورؤية مادية.
That's why there were always two lines and two paths, and two philosophies, and two universal views. One is the divine universal view, the plan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the divine put for us, and the other one, it is the materialistic one that always depends on what's happened in this life and the worldly life.
فلذلك هذه الرؤية هي التي تحدد مصير الإنسان وفهم الإنسان في أي عمل وأي تصرف يقوم به.
That's why it is this view that dictates upon us our path and our decision making and how we decide to take which path that we want to take.
الفارق الأساسي والجوهري بين هاتين الرؤيتين أن صاحب الرؤية الإلهية يعتقد أن هناك مبدأ وخالق وهناك معاد وجزاء وثواب وبين المبدأ والمعاد هناك حجة وهناك طريق رسمه الله سبحانه وتعالى لمن يريد أن يصل بين المبدأ والمعاد.
The main difference between the two views is that the divine plan for us is the belief that there is a start, there's a creator, Allah created us, and there is a hereafter where there's going to be a reward and punishment, and there's a path in between, between the start and all the way to the hereafter, that is full with the proofs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends us the different messengers and the proofs to guide us towards the right path.
أما الرؤية الثانية هي رؤية محدودة بعالم الدنيا. في هذه الدنيا حياتك ومماتك ولا شيء آخر، فعليك أن تصرف جهدك في استفادتك بهذه الدنيا فقط.
However, the second philosophy, the materialistic philosophy, it's all about this world and it's limited to this world from your birth until your death. That's why it leads you to always spend all your efforts and all your energy to make the most out of this world.
الرؤية الأولى تقول ارمي ببصرك وانظر إلى أقصى المسافة وإلى الهدف الأقصى ولا تنس نصيبك من الدنيا.
The first view, the divine view, it tells you look far away and look at the final goal and do not forget the final goal. However, also take whatever you can from this world too.
فلذلك الإنسان مخير بين أن يعمل لهذه الدنيا فقط وبين أن يعمل لكل الحياتين.
That's why the human has a decision whether he works only for this life or work for both lives, this one and the hereafter together.
وهذه الرؤية هي التي تعطيك أهداف في حياتك. الأخلاق مثلا، القيمة الأخلاقية هي أخلاق إنسانية، لكن شخص يعتبر الأخلاق لأنها فيها منفعة، وشخص يقول الأخلاق هي طريق إلى الله.
And this view also gives you the objectives for your life. For example, when we come to the ethics and mannerism, someone within this worldly view, he will say manners and ethics is something that's acceptable, but because it has some benefits. However, the divine view says manners and ethics are something good because it's a path towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فلذلك لأن الله جميل غني مدح نبيه بخلقه وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم، فالأخلاق لها هدف نهائي وهو رضا الله والكمال، بالإضافة إلى أن الأخلاق هي على طبق موازين الضمير الإنساني الحي.
That's why we find that because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty and He's the All Beautiful, the All Merciful. He describes His Prophet, إِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, that you are at the most of the manners and the ethics, as is describing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. This means that this akhlaq is a path to gain with Allah, to gain Allah's pleasure, and this is where it takes us towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَبَقِيَّةِ الْأَعْمَالِ أَيْضًا كَذَلِكَ تُرِيدْ أَن تَعْمَلِ. مَا مِقْدَار تَاجِر يُرِيدْ أَن يَرْبَح. لا أحد يريد أن يخسر، الكل يريد أن يربح، لكن ما هو المقدار الذي يربحه؟ هل المقدار الذي يربحه 100%، 500%، أو المقدار الذي يربحه هو مقدار معقول يحقق به رضا الله؟ عندما يكون هذا المقدار المعقول هو في نفع المجتمع.
And similarly with any other action, for example trading, a businessman was trading, he can profit. Every one of us wants to profit. Someone can profit 100%, someone can profit 500%. So how much profit is good? Is it a reasonable amount that it takes us to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or something that's beyond? So each of you would dictate the decision that you make of how much profit you should make.
هذه الرؤية لا تمنعك من الدنيا، ولا يوجد هناك مبدأ هو ترك الدنيا. الله سبحانه وتعالى خلقنا، أوجدنا في هذه الدنيا لإعمارها، سخر لنا كل ما في الكون لكي نكتشفه، نخترعه، نتعرف على سنن الله سبحانه وتعالى. لكن عندما نسأل لماذا؟ ما هو الحدود؟ ما هي حدود التي نسعى إليها؟ هل هي مطلقة بلا حد؟ أم هي محدودة بما يؤدي لنا ذلك الغرض وهو سعادة الدنيا والآخرة؟
This view, the divine view, the divine philosophy for us in this life does not prevent us from benefiting from this life and the worldly life. On the contrary, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He put the whole universe under our control, so we can create, we can find things, we can create new things, new techniques, we can establish and build the whole earth and make it towards a better place for us to live. And this is amongst the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do and wants us to perform. But the really question about the view is why. The why is the really question. Are we doing it? What are the limits? Because of the why would dictate the limits for us. The why is it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That dictates a limit for us. What are the limits for us to benefit from this life? So to gain, and this view, it tells you that you can benefit from this life for the sake of hereafter also.
الإنسان ليس آلة. الإنسان كتلة من المشاعر والأحاسيس. الإنسان مادة وروح. عندما يعمل يجب أن يكون هناك هدف، يجب أن يحصل على ذلك الاستقرار الروحي والفكري والنفسي حتى يستطيع أن يعمل. لذلك تكون أهدافه في حياته الدنيا هي أهدافه